This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas and Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare unto you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4, tell us what the gospel is, how that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to Scripture. He was buried. He rose again, third day, according to Scripture. Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He's anointed me to preach gospel to the poor, sent me to preach, heal the broken heart, preach deliverance to the captives, because of the sight to the blind, set at liberty them that are bruised. The word is nigh thee, even in my heart, in my mouth. This is a word of faith. So I preach, you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. With the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation. To everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. I want to welcome everyone receiving this broadcast on live stream, Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, or other devices. Thank God. Amen. To my right co-host, Terry Brown. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. To my left co-host, Kathie Davidson. Good morning.
Good morning.
Amen. And to your left co-host, Apostle Anthony Reece. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. And on the wire in Colorado, Kathie Courier. Good morning.
Amen. Good morning.
Thank you. Thank God. Thank God. We better get the mice out here. Amen.
Come on, come on.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank God. Thank God. Blessed be the name. They got it bad. 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 Thank God. They got it bad. They got it bad. Thank God. They got it bad. 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 I get
thanks.
I get it back.
I get thanks, Father.
Amen.
I get thanks.
This must be a stronghold.
Amen.
Amen. Which has a demon in it. Amen.
I get thanks.
I get it back.
I get thanks.
I get it back.
I get thanks, Jesus. I get
amen.
Jesus, I thank you.
Thank God.
I get thanks.
Amen.
I get
amen.
Thanks, Father, I thank you.
Thank you.
I thank you, Father.
Amen.
I thank
you. I got it back.
I thank you.
I got it back.
I thank you.
Thank
you. I get thanks, Father, I thank you. I get thanks.
Amen.
I get thanks.
Amen. 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 Well, Kathie, I'm going to start something here.
All right.
We talked this morning about the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Right?
Right.
And we said in Genesis 1, I believe it is.
Amen.
Says, let us, God said, let us make man in our image.
That is correct. Verse 26. Right. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion.
Make man. After what?
Let us make man in our image.
Us being the Father and Son.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Make man after our image and our likeness, right?
After our likeness, yes.
Amen. Now, I've been in the charismatic movement since 1970. I've listened to about every preacher that shows up. I listen to them. I've heard things misstated and certainly taught in error. And one of them happens to be the Holy Spirit and ministers will get up and they'll say, Holy Spirit, take over my lips, my tongue, take over me something.
Amen.
And minister, they can't do it. They cannot do it. Now, Kathie, would you turn to the book of John?
Already there.
You're there?
Yes.
So where are you going to read?
I'm going to read verse 13. He said, howbeit when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself. But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come.
He won't speak of himself.
Amen.
Amen. Well, did you read all?
I'll keep reading. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine and shall show it unto you. All things that the Father hath are mine. Therefore said I that he shall take a mind and show it unto you.
Amen. I must have been missing something here. Amen. He said, did you read this? He will not speak of himself.
That's right. I'll read that verse again. Verse 13. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak.
Now, that says, he hears it, then he speaks it.
Amen.
Right?
Right.
It's not from him.
Amen.
He hears it from the Father or the Son.
Amen.
Right?
Right.
You, in tongues, interpretation, prophecy, you hear the Spirit say, Amen. Saith the Father. Saith Jehovah. Saith the Lord of hosts.
Amen. The prophets of old said, they would say, thus saith the Lord.
Right.
Not thus saith the Holy Ghost.
That's right. Amen. Now, the body of Christ is full of heresy. And this is one of them. Amen. And I'm sure that you heard some great preacher you thought was great say all this stuff, so you start speaking it. Well, you see, I've listened to every preacher, and I don't say what they say. I say what the Bible says.
Amen.
Amen. And they just might be wrong. In fact, many times they are. And if they say the Holy Spirit can speak, what he believes, they're not telling the truth. They're deceived. Amen.
As this word says, he only speaks of what he hears.
Right.
So he never uses his own words.
Right.
So in the Word of God in the New Testament, and I can hear somebody saying this, when it says, the Spirit speaketh expressly, that some in the latter days, you know, that verse, that is God or Jesus speaking through the Spirit. The Spirit's only saying
Amen.
What the Father and Son say.
Amen. Thank God. So I trust that will help you, correct you, and get things straight. You know, at a Charles Simpson, I invited here once, and some preacher here in Plano called Charles, said, Doyle thinks he's got a ministry of correction and he'll rebuke you. Well, the guy that said that is just as wrong as he can be. He just said something that he didn't know what he's saying. It says, in the Word, Timothy, preach the Word,
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
Preach the Word, be instant, in season, out of season, right?
Right.
Reprove, rebuke, and exhort.
Amen.
That's by the Spirit of God. So, Charles wrote me a letter, and he said, I don't believe I'm going to come. And I said, why? Well, I don't want to come to Plano, get rebuked. I said, you think God would send you all the way to Plano to get rebuked? He can do it from here, from there.
He doesn't even need you.
That's right. And Charles said, well, Lord, I think I'm going to come on. I said, well, I think you're supposed to. God had me invite you. And so Charles came, and when I gave him the check, he said, boy, you are generous. No, God's generous.
Amen.
Don't give me any credit. God is generous. Jesus is generous. Amen. Now, what we're going to do next, Katie?
This is in my spirit to say, just to bring to everyone's attention, and it's simple when I say it, but we don't think about it much. There are only two thrones in heaven. There are not three.
Two what?
Two thrones in heaven.
Well, that's right.
Not three. There is the Father's throne, who is the God above all gods, far above all gods. And then Jesus sits at his right hand. There is not a throne for the Holy Ghost.
Right.
And it says in Revelation that when the new earth and the new heavens, that there won't be a sun, that the Father and the Son will be the light. Not the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Amen.
We were talking on the phone this morning about this topic. You called me and started sharing this with me. And as we were talking, it came up in my spirit how Jesus said, I and my Father are one.
Right.
He didn't say, I and my Father and the Spirit. He mm-hmm. said two. If there's three that are one, he would have said it. He said, I and my Father are one.
Is this cool?
Yes.
What God's doing?
He's correcting.
He sure is. With the word.
That's right.
There's another verse in John 15, verse 26. When the comforters come, whom I will send to you, that's Jesus, whom I will send to you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me.
Amen.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Glory. Hallelujah.
And we're not belittling the Holy Ghost. Amen. It's just where the Word has him placed.
Well, you belittle him to say he's going to talk through you.
Amen.
When Jesus...
His words.
Right.
No, he won't speak his words.
Amen.
Sorry.
Jesus said, pray to the Father in my name. We're never instructed to pray to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That's right. Hallelujah.
You have a testimony of years ago that you went to go visit a church. And you went to one of the meetings there. And when you walked out, I don't know if you went more than once, but I know you went at least once. And you walked out and you said, what is wrong? There's a wrong spirit here. What is wrong? And you saw later by the Spirit of God that they were magnifying and worshiping the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
Not Jesus and the Father.
That's right.
And that is an error.
Amen.
If you notice in Looking for a City, one of the lines of the song says, Father, send your Spirit, all our hopes renew. And that's based off of a verse. I can find it. I don't have the reference. But, you know, some songs say, oh, Father, we worship you. And then the second verse says, Jesus, we worship you. Amen. And the third verse says, Spirit, we worship you. We used to sing one here and you stopped it. Father, I adore you.
Right.
Jesus, I adore you. Spirit, I adore you. Stopped it because it doesn't line up with the word. And when we start singing Looking for a City, I was thinking about that. The Spirit, all our hopes renew. And I found the verse it's based on. But the line in the song says, Father, send your Spirit.
Amen.
All our hopes renew. And that's correct. That's right. According to the Word of God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Thank God. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. They got it bad.
I get that.
They got it bad.
Thank you.
They got it bad. Thank God.
I get
that. Got it bad.
I get that.
They got it bad.
You know, another verse that you showed us from the very beginning was how in Genesis, in the beginning, the Spirit moved and then the Lord spoke. The Spirit moved and God spoke. That's how he spoke, was through his Spirit.
He moved on the face of the earth, right?
On the face of the earth. And then he spoke and created all things by his word.
Upon the face of the waters, and then God spoke. The Spirit had to move first.
Right.
But once that Spirit moved, then God spoke. Let there be light.
Let there be
and
light.
There was light. The Spirit moved,
That goes right along, too, with 2 Corinthians 3, 4. We read, I think, yesterday about ministering by the Spirit.
Amen.
You have to have the Spirit. You have to minister by the Spirit.
Letter killeth.
Even the New Testament. The New Testament taught without the Spirit, taught in the letter, will kill you.
And Jesus even says that himself. He said, I can do nothing of myself. He said, what I hear, I speak from the Father.
Right.
Jesus would not move, would not speak until the Spirit.
Amen.
He was in the Spirit first.
And thank God.
That's how we do it.
I got it bad.
And he said, my words are Spirit and they are life.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank God.
I give thanks, Father. I thank you. I give thanks.
Thank you, Lord.
I give thanks, Father. I thank you, Father. I thank you. I thank you.
Amen. I get it bad.
I give thanks.
Thank God.
Thank you.
God, amen.
I get
it. I get it bad.
I give thanks.
I get it bad.
God, amen.
I get it bad.
I get
bad.
I get
bad.
I get bad.
I get bad.
God, amen.
Thank God.
Thank you.
I got it back.
I get thanks.
Thank
Father.
God.
Thank
hallelujah.
You. I get thanks.
Thank
Father.
God.
Thank
God. Thank God.
Thank you.
Thank God.
Thank
God.
Thank
God.
I get thanks.
Thank God.
Thank
God.
Thank
God.
I get thanks.
Thank God.
Thank
God.
I get thanks.
Thank God.
I get thanks.
Thank God.
I get thanks.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thanks, Jesus.
Thank God.
Thank God. Amen.
Thank God.
Thanks. I get
another couple of verses we talked about on the phone this morning. You're referring to Genesis, where God said, "Let us make man in our image."
Right.
Jesus told his disciples, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father.
Amen.
It's two places. It's in John 14 and John 15.
You've seen me, you've seen the Father.
Hebrews said that he is the express image of the Father. So he
Amen.
Looks just like
Thank God.
The Father.
Thank God.
Jesus, I thank you.
Thank God.
I give thanks, Jesus.
I'm after taking this. I had a young man working for me once when I was practicing veterinary medicine. And he used to ride with me in the car. And we were going someplace one day to see a horse. And he said, I'm having a flashback. I said, you're doing what? He said, I'm having a flashback. He said, I've seen God. You've seen God? I'm having a flashback. I said, what did God look like? He said, he's a big light. I said, that's the devil.
Amen.
That's the devil.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Satan appears as an angel of light.
Amen. Right. Thank God. Very good. Thank you.
Thanks, Jesus.
Thank
you.
Thank God.
I get
thank God.
Thank
God.
Thanks, Jesus.
Thank God.
Thanks, Jesus.
Thank God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank God.
I thank you, Father.
Thank God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank God.
Thank
God.
Thank God.
Thank
you.
Thank God.
Thank you.
Thank God.
Thank you.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God. Thank God.
Thank
God.
Thank God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I get thanks.
Hallelujah.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I get
thank God.
Thank God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank God.
Thank Jesus.
Thank God.
I get thanks.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you.
Somebody clap their hands. Thank God. Amen. Amen.
Thank
God.
Thank you.
7:1. Clap your hands, all you people. Shout unto God. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Glory! Thank God.
Amen. You mean not a voice of defeat?
What?
You mean shout with a voice of triumph, not a voice of defeat?
Glory! Amen.
I get thanks, Jesus.
Thank God.
I get thanks.
Amen.
I get thanks, Father. I thank you.
Thank God.
I get thanks. I get thanks. I get thanks, Father. I thank you.
Thank God.
I get thanks.
Thank God.
I get thanks. Thank
God.
Father.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank God. God with the voice of triumph.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank God.
Amen.
The word even says that you triumph in praise. You triumph in praise.
Right.
That's how you triumph.
I get
Amen. You feel the enemy.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank
God. Thank God.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
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 Hallelujah! Psalm 106 say?
I think that's the very last verse where it says triumph.
Amen. Is it triumph?
Next to last. Yeah, Psalm 106:47. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from among the heathen to give thanks unto thy holy name and to triumph in thy praise.
Amen.
Triumph in thy
praise. Thank God. Amen. Amen. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph.
Amen.
Thank God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank God.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God. Glory. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Voice of triumph, right?
Triumph in thy praise.
Amen.
Triumph in thy praise. Amen. And Psalm 22 says the Father inhabits praise.
Amen.
So I say if you're praising and the Father's inhabiting those praises, something's going to happen. He doesn't show up and just sit by and do nothing. How beautiful for the Father to inhabit our praises.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Amen.
Thank God.
Thank God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank God. Thank God.
Thank
God.
Thank
God.
Thank
God.
Thank
God.
Thank God.
Thank you.
Again, thanks.
Terry, would you read Psalm 8?
Yes.
Amen.
Glory!
Psalm 8. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings hast thou ordained strength because of thine enemies, that thou mightest still the enemy and the avenger. When I consider thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Thou madest him to have dominion over the works of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, yea, and the beasts of the field, the fowl of the air and the fish of the sea, and whatsoever passeth through the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth.
You just preach to the four corners of the earth.
Amen.
Amen.
That verse 2, out of the mouth of babes and sucklings thou hast ordained strength. Jesus says that again in Matthew 21, only he says, yea, have you never read, out of the mouth of babes and sucklings, thou hast perfected praise.
Amen. He's referring to Psalm 8, right?
He is referring back to Psalm 8.
Glory. Hallelujah.
So now we get that praise stills the enemy.
Amen.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Amen.
Thank God.
We've got the victory coming our way.
Amen.
Thank God.
Thank God.
This is going to be a church that praises God.
Amen.
Again.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God.
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 Matthew 21, what religious people disturbed because children were saying Hosanna or something
that
like
that.
That
is right. Jesus was on the ascension down the Mount of Olives.
Would you read that?
I sure will.
And he told them how foolish they were.
Amen. Actually, this is when Jesus was in the temple. Verse 12 of Matthew 21. And Jesus went into the temple of God and cast out all them that sold and bought in the temple and overthrew the tables and the money changers and the seats of them that sold doves. And it is said, and said unto them, it is written, my house should be called the house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves. And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. And when the chief priests and scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, and the children crying in the temple, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, they were sore displeased.
Amen.
And he said unto them, and they said unto him, hearest thou what these say? And Jesus said, yea, have you never read, out of the mouth of babes and sucklings, thou hast perfected praise.
Perfect praise shuts the devil's mouth.
Sure does.
There's another one when Jesus, when they brought the colt to him, is at the Mount of Olives. It's in Luke 19, says that they brought the colt to Jesus and they cast their garments upon the colt and set Jesus thereon. And as they went, they spread their clothes in the way. And when he was come nigh, even now at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice. For all the mighty works that they had seen. Have you seen any mighty works in your life?
Amen.
And saying, blessed, this is verse 38 now, saying, blessed Amen. Be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. And some of the Pharisees from among the multitude said to him, Master, rebuke thy disciples. He answered and said to them, I tell you that if these should hold their peace, the stones would immediately cry out.
Amen.
Love that.
I'm telling you, folks, I taught praise. I had praise tapes.
Amen.
Amen.
That's where we learned
That's
it.
That's where we learned all this.
Amen. And guess what? The devil didn't like them, tried to shut me up. And, you know, now we're all teaching Psalm 8, Matthew 21. Amen. Thank God, Luke, whatever that was. 19. Hallelujah. Thank God. Glory. Thank God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank God. Hallelujah. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God.
What time is it? It is 10:41.
10:41?
Yes.
I think we better get Terry Mai along with other Water of Life boys. I'm going to start saying it right. Terry Mai is a Water of Life boy.
Amen.
Amen. He was 30 when he came to me.
Amen.
Thank God. So let's get them going, and we'll keep praising the Lord and praying and
Amen.
Whatever God orders us to do along with them. Oh, hallelujah.
That goes right along with bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that's within me. All that's within me.
Amen.
Bless the Lord with your singing, your praying, your dancing, your praising, all that's within you.
Your hands.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't forget, folks, a bunch of you are fasting and praying for my deliverance.
Amen.
From oppression and division. Thank God. Amen. All right. Just a minute.
I get thanks. Thank you,
Lord. I've got to hear the Brown Mix Quartet, Amazing Grace. That's very much. Thank God.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
When these things beset us. He doesn't forget us. He sends down his love on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow white dove. He sends his pure sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove. When Noah had drifted on the flood many days, he searched for land in various ways. Troubles he had some, but it wasn't forgotten. God sent down his love on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow white dove. He sends his pure sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove. When my Jesus went down to the river that day, he was baptized in the usual way. And when it was done, on the wings of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow white dove. He sends his pure sweet love, a sign.
Terre and the boys.
Amen.
Turn them loose.
Send us his song. Praise, 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 in one accord we praise you, O Lord. Glory and honor and
Amen.
was dark in my heart. You brought light to me, a child of darkness became a child of light. And when my soul was so
thank you.
said, John, don't you weep. It was all part of the plan. And there in the middle of God's glorious throne, hallelujah, there stood a lamb. And they sang, worthy, worthy of honor and praise. They were casting down crowns and praising his name. And he said, are you worthy? I could hear Jesus saying, I am. Oh, praise God forever. There's to the
land.
Now open your Bible. Open your heart. It's clear we are in the last days. For he said, I'll come quickly. So don't be surprised.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, come, let us sing to the Lord, to the Lord. Give a joyous shout in the honor of the rock of our salvation. Come before him with thankful hearts. Let us sing.
the mightiest mountains all are his. Alleluia, 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 for the mightiest mountains all are his.
Shut up! greater than the power of sin, greater than the gates of hell, greater than anyone can tell, greater than the richest king, greater than anything, greater, oh, greater, greater, yes, greater. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. I've just broke through something in the spirit. The devil is dirty, and his people are likewise. Amen. Thank God. I was on television in Springfield, Missouri, Fox, I think it's 27. My goodness, I did meetings in Springfield at the Holiday Inn more than once. I'm gonna look it up as soon as I get somebody to read for me. Amen. 10 cities. Plano was my 10th. No, that's my headquarters.
Amen.
Springfield's a 10th.
Amen.
My goodness. I'm born 50 miles west of Springfield. Grew up there. Played football there. Thank God.
Is that where you saw the vision of the strawberries and the watermelon vine?
No, that was, oh my goodness. I was living there.
That's what I thought.
When that happened.
Yeah.
My goodness. You better know it was me. 70,
amen.
The day after I prayed with my sister, Betty, I said, who do I follow? Who do I get with? Open my Bible, John 15.
Amen.
I lived on 2 acres, south side of Springfield. Beautiful house. I didn't live it long. I thought we'd live there when I thought I'd stay in Missouri. But I didn't, but I'll be back. But that's exactly where I was at the day I had that vision. John 15. Amen?
Amen.
Anyway, don't y'all need to know, I'll be going east and west from Sargoxy. Mercy, grace, mercy, grace, mercy, grace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Amen.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.